My brother-in-law, who lives here locally, is in charge of selling the family condominium in Florida. And since he lives up here, as I said, he hired a real estate agent in Florida to sell his house and to do what we do with real estate agents. And I have to admit, she does a pretty good job of keeping in communication with the family up here. You know, even though it's a long distance relationship, she does a pretty good job. But every time she calls, and I mean every time she calls, her greeting is always the same, whether it's a voicemail or talking to you in person. And she says, "Hi, Rick. This is Barbie Big Bucks. You're a real estate professional working for you." I don't know about you, but for me, that comes across as kind of, creepy. It's just kind of so not Midwestern to hear someone saying something like that. They're just coming out and saying it. You know, our style more is to proofs in the pudding. You know, you do it. You act professionally and you do the work. And that's kind of what the message here is today, is while I'm not crazy about her method of doing it, that's just kind of weird. I do like what she's saying, because part of, you know, every time she's talking with her clients, she's reinforcing a couple of ideas. And those ideas are, one, she's professional, and two, she's working for you. And this kind of is the bottom line of what clients are looking for when they're working with us. So while I couldn't, you know, in a million years say that, well, without laughing out loud, I started thinking, what is a good way for us to accomplish the same thing, you know, of reinforcing the concept that we are professionals and that we are working for our clients. And for me, I think constant communication with your client is imperative. I would say if you're working with someone, and depending on the, you know, where you are in a relationship, but at a minimum of once a week, you should be in contact, and maybe a couple times a week. Especially when things are working towards a closing or a sale. So I like kind of a combination of email and calling in person. And every time you call or send an email, do it in a professional way. Make it with meaning, very clean, very organized, and adding value onto it and letting people know what you're doing for them this week. And if you are in contact, again, on a real regular basis doing this, you know, that is the concept. That's what they will start believing you are doing for them, and you're going to keep your clients. You know, case in point, twice this week, two separate agents in our company called me up, and we're sad because they had lost clients. Each of them had lost a client. Both of them had buyer's rep forms in place. I mean, this is not a casual relationship. These were formalized relationships, and both of them were lost. And, when I think back or in talking with them, I do think that both of those agents could have kept their clients had they done what we're talking about, keeping in constant communication, acting professionally, and, giving a statement of value, saying that, you know, we are, in fact, working for you. You know, in one case particularly, they had kind of a bump in the road, and the agent, because it was a friend, so there's some unique, you know, things going on there, but there was a bump in the road, and she didn't deal with it. She avoided the situation and just kind of let it die, essentially, and then was surprised when this person had gone out and bought another house, even though she had a buyer's rep form in place. And I think part of this, you know, acting the professionally is doing some of the hard stuff, doing things that we don't like to do. But I, in this case, had she contacted this buyer and been very upfront and direct and said, what happened, how can I do it better, and kept up the professionalism and here's what I'm doing to work for you, I think she could have saved the relationship. And so now, you know, she didn't. So, you know, bottom line here is communication is the key. This is what buyers and sellers want from us. They want to hear from us. Even if we have nothing to say in particular, you know, you always should be doing something of work and of value, for your clients. So you just need to find a way, your own personal way, of doing that on a real regular basis. So it's, communication and a statement of value. So this has been Kevin Sharkey, your real estate broker, working for you. I don't think so.